is addition of addition of water. Next is yes, electrophilic addition.
That's why he attached.
Addition of water. Write down. Alkynes undergo acid catalyzed addition of water. Alkynes undergo acid catalyzed addition of water in presence of mercuric ion as the catalyst.
So what's the name of this reaction?
It is addition of water on alkyne.
So under
the same thing, electrophilic.
So mercuric is
Hg+. Hg2+.
So what is single plus called?
Mercurus. Mercuric ion as a catalyst. Write on. Mercuric ion present as a mixture of mercuric sulfate, that is HgSO4, mercuric sulfate in aqueous sulfuric acid. In aqueous sulfuric acid. This reaction follows Markovnikov rule. Markovnikov rule. Write down. It forms enol first, which converts into keto through tautomerism.
So
like
keto and
tautomerism,
there
are some percentage. Yes. Haan, so we have 4-5 rules. Okay. That rules we'll discuss. Actually, you cannot find out the exact percentage. Yeah, exact percentage. But you can find out that which one, like in the given option, you can find out which one should be the 80, like suppose around 80% or 60% like that, or 100%. So suppose if you have a compound like this, this converts into what? This converts into phenol. After tautomerism, it converts into phenol. Just one example I'm taking. So okay, this H, one of the H will come out, right? This goes over here, this comes over here, and this H plus will attach onto this.
So you'll get this.
Space. So it comes over it, we'll get this, right? Since it is phenol, right, and it is aromatic, so we can say the composition of this is 100% in the way. This will entirely convert into this. So like that, based on the stability of the molecule, we can find out the percentage.
You did give us one way, right? That's something you find out the degree of the compound and then you count the number of alpha atoms. No, that was chlorination.
Yes, chlorination.
So it's only
chlorination composition for that. Percentage composition of the chlorinated products.
So that won't work for non-halo.
No, it did not. Okay, so reaction you write down CH3CH2. C triple bond CH. This on reaction with water, and the catalyst we use is H2SO4 in presence of HgSO4. This is the reagent for this reaction. H2SO4 with HgSO4. Okay, so in this the product is CH3CH2. C double bond CH2OH, the final product of the reaction. You'll get an alkene first. Right? What is the name of this compound? This we call it as enol. IUPAC name is what? 1, 2, 3, 4. Butte. Butte. 1-ene, 2-ol. Right? It's an enol form which goes under ketoenol tautomerism and converts into this CH3. Ruchir, Sato, kya ho product?
Yeah, that double bond go, it will become CH3 and this will be C double bond O.
So this becomes?
C double bond O and CH3.
Very good.
Reaction, what will be the percentage?
See, generally enol form is more stable. Like here we cannot compare the percentage. But enol form is more stable, not enol, keto form is more stable. Why? Because C double bond O, the bond strength, is higher than C double bond strength, right? So generally what we say, keto form is more stable than the enol form. So its percentage is around 60% will be this, or 65%, and this will be the rest, 35 or 40%. Okay, so exact composition we cannot say. We can talk about which one is more stable, and based on that we can say which one is more and which one is less. Okay, it is, like I said, it is spontaneous, right? So the structure which is more stable, the composition of that will be more in the mixture. Okay, in this case we can say as a stability. So sometimes what happens, the compound which forms after this tautomerism that get stabilized through hydrogen bonding, right? So ek mein hydrogen bonding hoga, ek mein nahi hoga. So the one which has the hydrogen bonding, the composition mode. Aise hoga. So uska we have 4-5 rules for that. So hum log kar lenge baad mein, right? Okay. So this is the reaction we have here. Okay, product. Hg2+. Here also what happens? This Hg2+ forms a cyclic ring here, intermediate, which is not that important. But if you try to understand the mechanism, it goes like this: CH3, CH2. The C will have Hg2+, C double bond, H, and then here what happens, H2O behaves as a nucleophile and the attack of H2O on the carbon atom which is more substituted, because it follows what? Markovnik option. So here say, we'll have attack of H2O, this will attack on the carbon atom which is more substituted, this ring will go up. Okay, what happens after this? CH3, CH2, COH2, positive charge, double bond, CH, Hg, 2+. Okay, this H+, comes from this OH2, it becomes OH, and this H+ will attach onto this carbon atom, so it forms what? CH2, yahan pe aa jayega OH, and this pi bond will not be there, so here we'll have the positive charge. So H+ yahan se bahar aaya, ye pi electron here shift kiya, and that pi electron takes this H+, so it forms CH2 and this positive charge over here. Now after this what happens, as Hg2+ goes out, and this bond pair is donated to this positive charged carbon atom. So kya ho gaya yahan pe?
C H G is good.
It is the metal, it won't take part in the reaction, it is a catalyst. Right. So we are using some temperature also here. At this temperature, here the elimination of H G ion takes place, which further combines with the sulfate ion forms HgSO4. What I said, mercurinium ion as a catalyst. So when it is a catalyst, it won't take part in the reaction. Right. So it comes out at the end of the reaction. Okay. So we'll get here C double bond CH2OH, which is this form, enol. After this, kya hoga? Keto form. Yahan se keto form kaise, how will it draw the keto form? Oxygen pair will have lone pair and hydrogen. This lone pair forms a pi bond, and this pi bond shift onto this carbon. And to stabilize this oxygen, because if you have double bond here, the oxygen has positive charge. To stabilize this positive charge, yahan se H+ bahar aayega, and this H+ is taken up by this CH2- becomes CH3. So ye hai mechanism. Okay, but again, like I said, mechanism is not important. Okay, only one thing you have to keep in mind, that whatever nucleophile you are taking, nucleophile is what here? What is a nucleophile? What is getting attached here? So what is a nucleophile?
H2.
No.
H2.
Nucleophile is H2. Nucleophile is always the molecule which attacks. So H2 attack kar raha hai. Yahan pe toh kya ho raha hai? H2 attack kar raha hai, right? Now, why OH we are getting here? Because the H2 attack here will have positive charge on oxygen. To stabilize this positive charge, H+ comes up. And then you get OH. So nucleophile is always the particle which attacks. Suppose, which is not possible in this reaction. Agar main yahan pe CH3OH leta hun, one hypothetical case I'm assuming. Right? So which one will attack? The whole this compound will attack here. CH3OH. So nucleophile is what? CH3OH. After this, kya hoga? H+ bahar aayega and we have OCH3. But the nucleophile is always CH3OH, H2O. JEE mein question puch chuka hai. What is the nucleophile in this reaction? So always remember, nucleophile is the molecule which attack, jo attack karta hai double bonded or electron deficient of region, whatever we have in the molecule. So H2O is a nucleophile in this reaction. Next reaction, write down. Hydration of alkyne by addition of borane. Borane humne kiya hai, hydroboration oxidation reaction based, same reaction hai. I'll just write down the reaction here. Hydration of alkynes by the addition of borane. What is the reagent we have here? Hydroboration oxidation reaction. Kya tha reagent batao? CH3 with NTHF or B2H6 bhi le sakte hain, because BH3 can exist in dimer form also, right? So BH3 with THF in the second state, what we take? H2O2 with OH-. You touch, right? Isme kya form hota tha pehle alkene mein? Trialkyl borane, R3B form karta tha pehle. If you remember that, aisa kuch agar tumhe yaad ho to. CH2 plus BH3. So first it forms what? CH3. CH2, BH2. You know that?
And then one more.
And then two times again the same reaction. So it forms CH3, CH2, thrice B, which is nothing but R3B, trialkyl borane, if you remember. Right? So here also we have same thing. Agar tumhe tum alkyne loge, suppose HC triple bond CH. Right? So 3 moles of this, it eventually gives you H2C double bond CH whole thrice B. We have CH3 C triple bond CH. Wait, I'll tell you. CH3 CH double bond CH. Addition of H2O2, OH minus will get attached, right? So OH minus will attack, next step mein H2O2, OH minus. So this forms CH3CH double bond CHOH plus BOH. 3 molecules, the reaction is not done. Okay, it is exactly same. So what is this product? This one. What is this product? Enol, right? So again, yahan pe kya hoga? Keto enol tautomerization, and eventually the product is CH3CH.
So why is the yogurt on the outer or top?
It's a carbonyl.
Keto enol we cannot say this one because this is not a keto. But the reaction is same. Similar way.
So why does it have to be asymmetric?
Symmetrical also you can take. So what happens?
You erase the symmetrical thing.
Because it is easier to understand with this, but you can write down the same reaction with this. I'll give you this one. With same reaction. Write down the product in this one. I think you'll get CH3CHO in this. Right. Not double bond won't be there. Carbon plus pi bond over there. CH3, CH1. CH3 single bond, CH. First of all, you get CH2 double bond, CHOH. And then tautomerism. So this H comes over here. CH3, CHOE. So terminal alkynes gives you aldehyde here. If you have non-terminal alkyne, then it will be a ketone. Then this keto in non-tautomerism. CH3, CHO. The first product is this. CH2 double bond, CHOH. And then it goes for tautomerism from CH3, C double bond, O. So terminal alkyne gives you aldehyde. Non-terminal gives you ketone. Two, three more reactions we have. Write down, next.
So do we also call carboxylic acids carbon compounds?
No, carboxylic acids are not carbon. Because what happens, carbonyl compound by definition is the molecule which has this group. Carboxylic acid mein, this carbon oxygen does not have double bond characteristics. Because in carboxylic acid what happens, C double bond O, OH. In some book, they have taken carboxylic acid also a carbonyl compound, right? But usually we consider only aldehyde or ketone as a carbonyl compound, because in carboxylic acid, or even if you take amide, C double bond O NH2, right? Here also we have resonance. So carbon oxygen does not have double bond characteristics here. That's why we don't consider this as carbonyl compound, aldehyde or ketone.